Hi, this is Rolando.
This is Rolando Chang Barrero.
And Deon.
And Deon.
Jefferson.
Yes. Jefferson.
Hey, yes.
honey, how are you excited about today?
Okay, well, okay,
we're
well,
on Lake Worth
we're
here,
on Lake Worth
and we're
recording,
and we're recording
Bigger Love.
Bigger Love
by Perterson, yes. Toscano.
Yes.
And you'll get to enjoy it in a little bit.
This is part of
Climate Change Action Theater 2019.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned
and enjoy the play.
And enjoy the play.
Climate change is a threat multiplier. This is not just weather patterns and events, but also to existing social conditions.
If on a pleasant Sunday day, someone experiences challenges in regards to housing, policy, care, mobility, and what happens when a stream of weather events hits.
While every other event is affected,
some are affected more for a longer period after the weather event. While we are all on the same boat together, we are not all on the same deck. Some inspiration for the same plague, while Toscano just researched for an article published by the American Public Health Association in the same boat, not the same deck. Toscano was inspired by the following queries: Who are the climate action figures of the future? As impact magnifies, how will empathy and care increase?
Okay, so here comes the fun part.
The characters.
Who's the character?
You're Kyle.
Yes.
You want to be Kyle?
Yes.
You're a 27-year-old white cisgender guy. I am a 31-year-old black guy. Oh my God. Okay. Can you play that role? You want me to play that role? I can totally do it. Let's see.
Okay, so
Kyle is a
27-year-old white cisgender
gay man.
Gay man.
Check.
That's me.
Not really.
Anyway.
Originally from rural Missouri, I have no fucking clue. Anyway, studied art in history, I did that. Works at workshop in Museum of Art, never. I sell my shit there. I'm doing it. I'm doing it. I'm 29, 29, 29, cisgender, bisexual, bisexual, Puerto Rican, never. But we're gonna do it from New York.
I graduated. 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 I graduated
shirt, I put my backpack, on the floor.
You're going to have to pretend, that there's a backpack here.
Okay, remove my shoes.
You don't want to see my feet.
You don't
want to
see my feet,
honey.
And then lots of shoes at the entrance. That's like my bedroom.
Yes.
Okay. So.
Start again.
Hey, I'm home.
I'm in the bedroom.
Gosh.
It's crazy out there still.
There's food in the kitchen. That's Sammy, man.
Oh, no, I'm good.
He's a good cook.
I don't like all that free food, honey.
You know, free of meat, dairy, gluten, and flavor.
I get that he's vegan.
We know.
Hey, you.
Have you noticed Sammy looks great?
But he has really bad breath.
Yeah, I know.
And he kind of hovers too.
Well, they all hover.
So how did the art move?
We barely got a dent. The med had over a million pieces in that underground tunnel.
It's a miracle.
None of it got damaged.
Some guy from the mayor's office.
Every basement in the city got flooded this time.
Still flooded in some places, I heard. So where are they moving to?
Undisclosed location.
Someplace upstate, I bet.
Or slop off.
Where they store the strategic art reserves.
I actually got the backup in Hudson Hartley.
Who would have thought that farm boy from Missouri would have been handling priceless pieces of art?
Big deal. I get to handle priceless pieces of art every day.
Oh, honey. Where is everyone?
Well, let's see. Sammy's out foraging.
Dumpster diving.
Sure.
Jenna actually has an audition for drag review.
She likes being into trans and doing drag all at the same time.
Nino is, who knows?
He said he was going to see if they were open again.
He's got no response there, so I think Louis is someplace doing laundry.
Oh, by the way, he wants to know if you have any extra meds he could borrow.
He's not been able to get in contact with his doctor.
I think so. What's up with his doctor?
Well.
He's in Long Island.
What the hell is he going to a doctor in Long Island for?
It's complicated.
But he said she's the only friendly doctor in all of New York.
It's 2028.
I was just reading this terrible story. This trans woman, after a storm, cut off her leg, with some debris, she went on to an emergency room with a clinic shitting her like she was shit.
Oh, it just sucks. Well, they're all gone. You know, this is the first time we've been alone in the apartment since the refugee crisis.
Yeah, I think you're right.
So do you think we should move?
Hey, not that again.
I think a lot of people are.
You know, a lot of people can't.
I'm just glad we have this place and can take care of some people.
Maybe we can see about getting a bigger apartment or something.
A hostel for the weary, storm-driven New York City.
It's something. It's community.
We could do more to help.
Oh my God.
You totally sound like Mayor Morales.
Biggest storms need bigger love.
Well, it's true. And what's wrong with bigger love?
Now we're alone.
You're thinking about big love, honey?
Well, I miss you too.
And I'm feeling the atmospheric pressure dramatically changed.
Oh, has it?
There's a brewing storm, a big nasty storm.
Oh, it's right here, city boy. What do you do now?
The swirling pressure and heat are building up the storm surge.
Oh, the storm surge.
Let's lock the door.
Oh shit, somebody's coming back.